vision. But each day well lived makes every yesterday a dream of happiness and every tomorrow a vision of hope. Carrying the same vision, we, the International Institute of Health Management Research Family, successfully complete 10 glorious and tremendous years of its existence at the national capital, New Delhi. Good morning to one and all present here. I am Manvik Kaushik.
And me, Rashi Singhal.
From second year, welcomes you all to the Open Day 2019.
A joyful good morning to our director, sir, Dr. Sanjeev Kumar, Dr. Pradeep Panda, sir, who is the professor and dean, academics and student affairs, Dr. B.S. Singh, sir, who is dean research, and all the respected professors of IIHMR Delhi.
IIHMR Delhi was set up in 2008 to focus on breaking international standards and benchmarks to all the four areas, that is research, academics, training, research and consultancies. It is done by reaching out to international agencies located in Delhi and outside the country to cater the growing needs of the country and the Asia-Pacific region.
The institute offers a two-year full-time postgraduate program with specialization in hospital management and healthcare information technology.
Now, I would like to introduce Dr. Pradeep Panda, sir, who is the Dean for Academics and Student Affairs. He is a health economist as well as a demographer by training with significant experience in teaching, research and consultancy. Prior to joining the IIHMR, he has worked in reputed national and international organizations in various capacities.
He has a strong background in mixed method research, impact evaluation and systematic reviews. He was awarded two visiting research fellowships to conduct research at International Institute of Social Studies. Now please put your hands together and welcome Dr. Pradeep Panda to please come up on the stage and welcome the students and parents.
A very good morning to all of you. On behalf of our director, Dr. Sanjeev Kumar, at the International Institute of Health Management Research, New Delhi, my colleagues, both academic and non-academic staff of IIHMR Delhi, our current students who are helping us and who are available today with us, and other dignitaries who have come from outside, it is my great pleasure to welcome the prospective students who have come here, their relatives, friends and parents. Thank you very much for coming. I think you have come to the right institute and to the right place, and you will get a clear perspective in the next presentation by our director why you should be choosing IIHMR Delhi. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to introduce our director, sir, Dr. Sanjeev Kumar, who has 41 years of experience in public health across 29 countries. He has wide experience of public health from grassroots level to top across the globe.
Dr. Sanjeev Kumar has published more than 100 papers in scientific and popular magazines and chapters in books. His current focus is on leadership and strategic management in health and health research. He is a committed teacher, always keen to teach, enriching his classes with his rich national and international experience. He is excited to be back to teaching as director, International Institute of Health Management and Research in New Delhi. Now, may I request to our director, sir, Dr. Sanjeev Kumar, to please come up on the stage and share a short presentation on the changing health scenarios and growing needs for our health managers.
Thank you. My privilege and honor to welcome all potential students, their parents, guardians, and I'm sure some of you have come with friends. So you are all welcome to IIHMR. I also welcome our students who are in the back row, our faculty, and visiting professors. Dr. Ajay Sood and adjunct faculty, Dr. A.K. Agarwal. In my presentation, I will take you through the glimpses of what is happening in health in India and what is changing. The health scenario is changing rapidly, and with that, what is the scope of professionals in health management, and then come towards the end on why IIHMR Delhi. I will prefer those of you in the last row to please come in the front. No, not students, the visitors and their parents. Please come. There are seats which are vacant. Not to be confined to that end of the room, but then somebody is recording, so I need to be in the view of the camera. So what we will be looking at, I will start with a question, and only the students who are appearing in the interview are eligible to answer. Students are not eligible to answer. Is health status of Indians changing? Yes? How many of you say yes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, almost everyone, all right. So you have answered the first one. If yes, is it getting worse? How many of you say it is getting worse? Health situation in India is getting worse. Raise your hand. Don't hesitate. It is the same? How many of you say it is the same? And how many of you say? It is getting better. Wow, good. I am very happy. You have done your homework. Everyone is right. So we all agree that it is getting better. Alright? Okay, let's move to the... Why is it getting better? So there are many factors which are contributing to it. Technology breakthrough. Big data, artificial intelligence, machination, digital record, connected data, virtual hospital, many more. So things are changing. Demographic shift. You have a lot more people in my age group than you had earlier. From 61 to 2011, the number of people above 60 has gone up 4 times. We'll look at the data. Disease epidemiology. You hear a lot more about blood pressure, cancer, and related diseases. Urbanization. Lot of people are moving to cities. The place where I live was called South Extension because it was extension of Delhi in the south. Now you have 20 kilometers beyond South Extension, the colonies have, because South Extension is no longer extension of South Delhi. So things are changing. Population is increasing in cities. Economic development. India is known as an economic superpower. So we are making a lot of progress. And then political agenda. Health was not on political agenda, but now both the parties, the main parties, are claiming that they will do a lot more for health, and they are doing a lot more for health. And some of the programs are monitored by people like Prime Minister himself. Technology breakthrough. Continuing, you can look at lot more. And you, if you come to IIHMR Delhi, you have an advantage. You have health IT specialization. Those of you who take health and hospital management also will get exposed to health IT. Because that is what is going to change your work. Even if you opt for hospital management, you will rely lot on how IT is helping you, keeping records, human resources, operations, supplies, procurement, etc., etc. So it's very important for you to come to an institution like IIHMR Delhi, where you have health IT mainstreamed into teaching. We talked about life expectancy. in last 26 years, from 1990 to 2016, it has increased from about 60 years to 70 years. And if you calculate, you will find that every year an average Indian's lifespan is increasing by 4 months. So you will have a lot more elderly people. You have to be prepared for. And why is it improving? Many factors which are contributing, including healthcare, which is one of the factors. Growing economy means more money for health. Government, when the Ayushman Bharat program was launched, they were doomsayers who were saying, itna paisa kahan se aayega? So it has been running for 1 year and nobody has been returned back. There is no money to provide services. So more money means more for health. And then, over those 26 years, the killers have shifted. This red one was infection, maternal child health, nutrition related diseases. It has come down to about half. Non-communicable diseases have almost doubled. What are non-communicable diseases? Cancer, hypertension, strokes, etc. India is making good progress, we saw the data, but we are still behind world average, we are still behind Bangladesh and Nepal, which are not economically as developed, not technology superpower, not space superpower. So we are, as they say in boxing, we are hitting below the belt. We are capable of doing much below our weight. Healthcare sector is growing fast. If you look at last 5-6 years, rapid growth has gone up. If you look at economic terms, it's gone up fourfold. And then if government is not creating government hospitals or increasing number of beds in the hospital, private sector will come in. I have nothing against private sector. They are providing services where government is not able to provide services. And these are the people who employ a lot more of our graduates. When they pass out from MBA, you have a much fast growing market in private sector. Then, new dimension, Niti Aayog driving health initiative. Dr. Vinod Paul was chief, he is going to come again. He was here for our research day. He is going to be our chief guest at the convocation, which is on 21st of June. And we will send you invitation so that you can come and listen to him. So we are in touch with the people who are driving what will happen in health sector. And yesterday I was in a meeting chaired by Dr. Vinod Paul, looking at public health cadre in India. And the Niti Aayog and the government people have decided they will roll it out in all states in India. Next, in about 15 days after the new government takes over, they will have consultation with the states. That what does it mean? It means lot more jobs for you. Health managers in hospitals, also in national health program, the number will grow. All of you heard about Ayushman Bharat, also popularly known as Modi Care, driven by a gentleman called Dr. Indu Bhushan. He has also visited us once and you will see him more often. Being in Delhi, having our name, we get all these dignitaries to come and visit and talk to our students quite often. What will happen under Ayushman Bharat? Sub-centers will become health and wellness centers. These are the health centers which provide services for 5,000 population. Essentially, in the past, they were providing family planning, maternal child health, and communicable diseases which were of national health importance. What will happen in health and wellness center? Lot more focus on non-communicable diseases, which are killing about 2/3 of the people who die. Lagbhag 1 crore log marte hain Hindustan mein ek saal mein. Usme se 60 lakh ke lagbhag non-communicable diseases se marte hain. 12 lakh ke lagbhag injuries se marte hain. To 72 lakh marte hain. 28 lakh mein unhi ko services de rahe the abhi health sub center. That is going to change, and it is changing as we are talking about it. The National Health Agency has come up, led by Dr. Indu Bhushan, and is providing hospital care. A lot more hospitals from private sector are involved than public sector hospitals, and they are estimating next couple of years 2,000 to 3,000 new private hospitals will come up. That again means more jobs for our graduates, and there are many more initiatives. You need many more health managers, and I use the term. We have our students who come from army, many brigadiers and full colonels. When you join, you will interact with them. So I use the term they use to do surgical strike on disease and disability. We talked about public health cadre. Why MBA? Five reasons. One says go for pioneer institution. Don't go to any MBA anywhere. There are many institutions. MBA general, and then it'll be not as easy for you to get a job in health sector. So go to pioneer institution like IIHMR, which was first to start in 1984. Nobody had thought of health management when this institution was started as a society in Jaipur. Recent survey has shown that IIHMR Jaipur and Delhi are among the top 100 business schools. They looked at not just health school. If they look at health school, we will be probably number 1 and 2. Health management, we are number 1, and we have 3 campuses. We are sitting in Delhi, we have one in Jaipur, and we also have a campus in Bangalore. More than 2,000 alumni, and many times the recruiters come here, they are alumni. They passed out from Delhi or Jaipur or Bangalore. Excellent placement record. Now even the remaining 2 students have been placed. So we have near 100% placement record in IIHMR Delhi. These are the reasons you look at when you decide on an institution. Why IIHMR Delhi? IIHMR, the first I in IIHMR Delhi stands for international. So when they realized that IIHMR Jaipur is not bringing international standards, they created one institution in Delhi, and the objective was to bring international benchmarks and standards. Not just to IIHMR Delhi, but to the whole group. Exposure, you have renowned faculty, many of them are sought after by international organizations. Many of us have done consultancies in Asia, in Europe, or even in US. Globally renowned experts in government, international agencies are available in India. For example, Dr. Ajay Sood, a renowned academician in health management, was a professor in National Institute of Health and Family Welfare. If you offer him a job outside, he will not go. But he is kind enough to be a visiting faculty here. So you have many such faculty. We have at least 10 visiting faculty, in addition to 2 adjunct faculty members. Dr. A.K. Agarwal was heading the Department of Hospital Management in National Institute of Health and Family Welfare. He was involved in setting up School of Health Sciences in IGNU and is chair of many reputed health-related bodies. So we are fortunate in having him. We have another adjunct faculty, Dr. Satish Kumar. He was in UNICEF. He headed 3 offices of UNICEF before superannuating, and he is our adjunct faculty, bringing in a lot of international experience and experience of bringing other sectors to improve health. So you have that advantage. Globally renowned expert. We are in Delhi, so we just give them a phone call, they are ready to come. But if I call them outside Delhi, they will say, nahi, mere ko to 2 din aane jaane ke lagenge, main nahi aa sakta. So that's the advantage we have. So many international experts visit Delhi, we request them to come and talk to our students. Much larger healthcare industry in Delhi, whether we like it or not, Delhi has much larger health industry, and that's probably one reason why 100% of our students get placed. All ministries and renowned institutions are also in Delhi. So when you go on field visit, if you come from another city, you have to make arrangements for students, faculty to travel. Here we just pick up the phone, talk to them, and our students can reach there within an hour. one of the few institutions with specialization in health informatics. And as I said earlier, it is health informatics which is revolutionizing health and hospital care. And you have an advantage that you have specialists teaching health informatics here. We have a lot more flexibility in academic. We are in the process of revising the curriculum. Those of you who join will be exposed to academic with the revised curriculum. Excellent placement record, I have talked about it. We have a lot of international collaboration, and as we are discussing, we are expanding our international collaboration. So name a few, International Data Sciences Institute, University of California, San Diego. We are collaborating with them in revising all HMIS evaluation and related modules with their inputs, and they have agreed kindly to do it free of cost for us. Then we have an arrangement with a university in Indonesia. One of our students went there for summer internship. Those of you who want to get exposure outside India, such institutions will be of help. And then EU-funded project in Bangladesh, we do training for them, and if any one of you is interested, can go there for your internship. And then there are many, many more within India and outside. Then I was talking about guest lectures, international. So we have had John Bulbers, Anita Raj, Ramesh Jain, Professor David Peters, Abhishek Ghatani, and Dr. Keswan. And we need to update the list to include the current Dean of John Hopkins University, Dr. McKenzie, who also visited here and talked to our students. Then we have experts in India. Dr. Anand Krishnan is Professor, Center of Community Medicine, nationally and internationally renowned experts in non-communicable diseases. Dr. Santosh Jain Parsi was the Director Principal of Institute of Home Economics and a nutrition expert. She has been coming. And Dr. Bhagat Chandra, who owns two hospitals in Delhi. So these are the people, we tap into their expertise and they come and talk to us. Then some of the conferences, Dr. V.K. Paul came as chief guest on our research day. You will be exposed to that as well. The research done by our students is showcased to these experts. So they come to know what we are doing in the field of research, and you get exposure to the people who are well established in the field of research. Dr. Indu Bhushan, I mentioned, the person who heads National Health Agency, National Health Protection Scheme of the Prime Minister, is supervised by him. Dr. Sarup Sarkar was Director in WHO Regional Office. Dr. Dinesh Agarwal, Director of Health Nutrition in a private company which works on health IT global, and Manoj Jalani, who is the boss of National Health Mission, additional secretary and mission director. Then we have very rich and vibrant research portfolio, and we have international organizations and national organizations. You take a name of any reputed organization in India and abroad, we are partnering with them. In terms of areas, we are almost the whole spectrum of health we are covering in our research portfolio. And what we are doing is we are mainstreaming research in our students' teaching academic activities. We keep regularly updating, and some of our students are involved in research projects. I don't see Jesse in the room. One of our students who is passing out this year has been absorbed as a research officer in one of the research projects because she showed a lot of promise during her work in a research project. So you have those advantages. Then we are always proud of our students. Four of our students got WHO award, cash award of $1,000. This student went to Indonesia for doing summer internship and presented a paper which was at an international conference which was highly appreciated. Umang went to US and represented IIHMR in a gathering of youth from all over the world. Priyesh received a recognition at an international public health conference. There are many more. I'm not presenting how many papers they have presented, the large number of papers, and we encourage every student to present a paper from the summer assignment and from their dissertation. Often, those who come to Jaipur and also come to Delhi also go to Jaipur. We are competing with each other, a friendly match. What Jaipur is doing, we should do better. And what Jaipur feels, what Delhi is doing, we should do better. But in one area, we outscore. That is placement, because we have 100% placement record compared to Jaipur. In other areas, they are slightly better than us, but we are making an effort to become better than them. So friendly match is always going on between us and Jaipur. In service training, this is in charge of National Urban Health Mission, Dr. Preeti Pant, in Ministry of Health. We had organized a workshop, a series of workshops for engaging medical colleges in improving national urban health through the medical college engagement. So you have many glimpses. This is for Tibetan administration. We did a training for them and many more. We picked up only a few pictures. We also get people regularly to come from Bangladesh, from Nepal. Recently, me, Dr. Agarwal, Dr. Jigme went to Nepal. They have adopted a constitution to decentralize governance. And what are the implications for health? So we went there to train the trainers, and then subsequently all the functionaries in Nepal in health system will be trained. And we have prepared a roadmap for that. So we are involved in Sri Lanka, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, and we have Dr. Jigme, who is a renowned public health expert globally. He has been a minister in health minister in Bhutan. He has also been in WHO regional office and also WHO representative. And currently, there is a global fund. They release billions of dollars to assist the countries and also providing technical support to the secretary of this region. Thanks, Dr. Jigme, for joining us. Then a question which is asked often and continue till you take our first year students are still grappling with that. So with which stream, health, hospital or health informatics, you should be joining? We have three specializations. And what does it give you? If you specialize in hospital management, these are the partners who have been. Name a hospital which is worth its name in India. They employ our students. Vedanta, Fortis, JP, Artemis, Rockland, Akash Healthcare, Max Healthcare, Patra Hospital, Asian Hospitals, and so on. And if you specialize in health management, some of our students have reached WHO, some have reached UNICEF, NHSRC. When you go to NHSRC, you will find at least 8-10 students. Whenever I visit there, I was heading NHSRC before I came to IIHMR. All the students dod ke aate hain, sir, we are from IIHMR. So it's good to go there. National Health Mission, I went to Gujarat again, 8-10 students or alumni came running to meet me. Public Health Foundation is another place where many of our students go. Health informatics, you name it. Any organization, worth it, Accenture, Deloitte, Dell, they take our students. There are many more. I will just put a few here. Criteria for admission, your marks in graduation, you have to score more than 45% in general category. In privileged category, 45% is the cutoff. You have to appear in management aptitude test. We don't normally use a cutoff. We look at your management aptitude so that we can work on it. Those who have not done MAT, next one is coming up on 18th of May. Selection is based on group discussion and interview, and admissions will close on 30th of June, and classes will start on 1st of July. Question, many parents who come from outside look for hostel accommodation. For girls hostel, we have 4-storied building. We have 24/7 security, and the food arrangements have been made by the institution. This is the building where, and this is a glimpse of the room where girls stay. For boys, we have paying this accommodation near the institute. Most of our boys take rent an apartment, 3-4 of them get together, or take a paying guest accommodation. Normally, first thing they do is take paying guest and then they go for renting an apartment. Wo teen char friend ban jate hai na, to wo mil karke fir ek apartment le lete hain. And food arrangements are in the cafeteria. Scholarship? Any one of you has scored more than 70% in your graduation? Come to the front, ताकि वो वीडियो में आपका फोटो आ जाए. Your name?
Sneha Purana.
This is for you. And you?
Shraddha.
Five of you. What's your name? Camera की तरफ. Balaji. हाँ, आपसे तो मुलाकात हुई थी सर. कल मिला था. You?
Rishabh Agarwal.
And you?
Gulshan.
Gulshan, बोलो. इनाम मिल रहा है. Alright. Why I specially called you? You will get scholarship. And 25% of our students get scholarship. So in the first year, they will have 50% of the tuition fee exempted for you. So good, congratulations. So we look for more students like you who bring a different level in our interaction in the classes. Thank you. And those who are MBBS, anyone from MBBS background? Okay, kitna number hai? 60 men.
Thank you.
Your name?
I'm Dr. Fatima.
Fatima, that's a good idea.
My name is Santosh Medical
College. Oh, okay. One of my friends was there. Uh-huh. I don't know after time to pay anything. Dr. Devki Nandi. All right, congratulations.
Thank you.
This is what we have. Those who have scored 50 to 60%, we also waiver some. Tuition fee for them as well. Education loan, many of our students, again around 1/3, they feel that they cannot afford, so they go for loan and we help that. So 25% take it, and we have also looked at kitna time lagate hain loan wapas karne mein. So they return the loan normally in less than 2 years. So the package they get is attractive, so they are able to pay back the loan. And IIHMR will facilitate the documentation, etc., so that you can take the loan. Then the fee is in 5 installments. So the first installment within 10 days of admission was like 10,000, and normally those of you who want to confirm your seat can pay 50,000, and then the remaining you can pay. Second one within 20 days. Then third installment up to 5th December, and in the second year in March and in the month of July. Faculty. So we have many other commitments, so all our faculty are not here, but I will request them to come forward. We will start with Dr. Jigme. I have told you, please give your opinion.
Experience in a corporate or a private sector. Before that, I was in the government sector, the public sector. So this is my first experience in a private institute and or a corporate institute. Very rich experience. I've learned a lot, gained a lot, particularly in the area of management, administration, research, and also had an opportunity to interact with various colleagues at various levels and with various backgrounds. And as our director was mentioning to you all, particularly with the senior officials, very high senior level officials in the government of India, as well as Delhi being the seat of all the, you know, international agencies and organizations, also gives you an opportunity to meet with a lot of international agencies, development partners. So I think if being in IIHMR Delhi, it gives you, besides the academics, I think extra edge in meeting, in exposing, in interacting, and that is a big advantage in life. So I would like to wish you all, those of you who will continue in this institute, a very, very best wishes for a very successful academic as well as extra academic, you know, areas where you can interact and actively pursue your profession. Right. Thank you very much.
We have another renowned health management professional and then
thank you, sir. Good morning to all of you and welcome to IIHMR. Well, thank you, sir, for saying already he has introduced me. My name is Dr. Ashok Kumar Agarwal, a medical graduate of late 60s or early 70s from AFMC Pune, and then joined the Central Health Service and worked in various organizations. And after my post graduation, MD from NIHFW and DNB in hospital management, health management, I joined Safdarjung Hospital, Delhi, as the assistant medical superintendent. And after that, as already mentioned, joined the Department of Medical Care and Hospital Administration at NIHFW, from where Dr. Rajesh Sood is already here. And then joined IGNU as the Director School of Health Sciences way back in 96 to then I retired from there in 2012. And you see, so I took the decision to join the health sector way back in 1970s actually. I preferred, please come, Dr. Tiwari. You see, I took a plunge into the health management, hospital management right in mid-70s, leaving the clinical career. Didn't really want to pursue the clinical side, so, and I have no regret because as a hospital and health manager, probably I could do more and is still trying to do something in hospital health management even now. And then I joined here as the Dean Academics, which my successor, of course, is Dr. Sudhir Panda. And now, Director is gracious to keep me as adjunct professor here. What I'm trying to say is that, you know, the famous management group, Peter Drucker, has said that nearly 80 to 90% of the problems or deficiencies in any sector, whether education or a university or a hospital, say example in health sector, are not because we don't have good doctors or good nurses. It is because we don't have good systems in place. And that's where we need managers, you know, like you, who will be the managers in health and hospital and IT management. Because the systems are weak and we need to make the health sector more vibrant. And as sir pointed out, we need so many million doctors and nurses, but we need the managers more than anybody else actually. You may have the best doctor, but the hospital. I did a consultancy for ONGC hospital, sir. So ONGC hospital, Dehradun, Panvel is now closed, and Sip Sagar in Assam. And I tell you, ONGC is a Navratna company, no dearth of resources. But the people in ONGC were not satisfied with the services provided by ONGC hospital in three places. Because the systems were not there, managers were not there to manage the resources, you know, to manpower, equipment, and all those kind of things. So I think there is a big gap which people like you, when you pass on from IIHMR, and I'm sure that you are going to fix those systems and improve the vibrancy of your organizations. So welcome back, and I'm sure you will never regret joining IIHMR. It's one of the finest institutions from my experience. I've been associated since 1985 with IIHMR Jaipur and then Delhi now. Thank you, sir, for giving me this award.
Thank you, Dr. Tiwari. First, I apologize for being delayed here because of traffic jam and some official commitment. One hour, sir, I'm sorry. Otherwise, I always to be
No, your time should have been for interview, not for this. So, I'm glad you came.
So, I'm really thankful to Sanjeev sir and Dean Panda sir and other senior faculty. And I am really privileged to be here at IIHMR. And I have been associated with IIHMR last 30 years. You know, my first appointment was with late Professor Ramesh Sharma sir at IIHMR Jaipur. So for some time I worked, then I shifted to NIHW. And I am coming here for taking sessions on monitoring and evaluation and operation research in hospital administration. So I love to be associated with IIHMR. I wish all success for the new aspirants who are willing to come here and join the courses, and I think they will really achieve what they want to achieve, and they will excel in future. So this is one of the best institute in health management. I think in India no other institute is giving such kind of training and field assignment and the practical exposure. I have evaluated many theses also. I have been interacting with the faculty and the students also. It is one of the best. And if you have decided to be here, I think you are lucky to be here, sir. Thank you very much.
You will see, if you join here, many faculty from AIM, from NIHFW and other reputed institutions in Delhi will come and take some classes for you. Thank you, Dr. Tiwari. Dr. Ajay Sood.
Good morning to all of you. From the presentation of our director, what we have learned, there are two things which are, as a parent, as a student, you are concerned. One is the placement of the thing. Okay, it's very important. What I will do after spending some time over here. And Dr. Sanjeev has said that 100% placement. So that is very rare for an institution. So that should be a very important point when you are considering where to go. And second part is the quality of care. Because ultimately, what you do in the field depends on the training which you have undergone here. Okay, so you may be the topper, but if you are not able to do the work allotted to you after the training, so you will not be given the credit. So for that, the quality of training is very important. And as you might have seen, personally, I know Dr. Sanjeev for a very, very long time. We were together at teams when we were with MD. And I personally feel that there is no one else in India with such a vast experience in public health. He has international experience, national experience. He has studied in national institution for 3 years. So that is one fact. Because for quality training, 4 things are important. So one and the very important thing is the trainer, teacher, facilitator. So here we have the fortune to have the best teachers. Because as he said, the central government is here, so many institutions are here. And he has already seen this, such a vast such a vast experience. And second is the material, learning, training method. So being in Delhi, you have access to national, international resource center. That another important point is the student effort. So unless you make an effort, the quality will not improve. So I hope that the type of students which are coming to this place, as just we have seen 70% and 50%. So I personally feel that this will be a great opportunity for all. And regarding my introduction, I did my MBBS long time back in 1979 from Indore Medical College, now it is IIHMR Medical College. Then I did post-graduation from Holiday Institute of Medical Sciences in 83. I was working as a senior resident for 2.5 years. Then I joined Medical College also as a faculty. I was there for 6 years. And in 91, I joined Professor Agarwal and Dr. Tiwari at National Institute of Health and Family Welfare as Associate Professor. I became Professor. And meanwhile, I had also deputation to National Board of Examination as Executive Director for 6 years. And I retired in 2017. So now I am sort of making that academic contribution wherever possible. So I am also privileged to be there associated with the research related activities. Especially Dr. Sanjeev, I've been calling you for your presentation of the research group. So I wish you all the best, and I'm sure that most of you will like this presentation. All the best.
आपने जो जो क्वालिफिकेशन नहीं बताए अपने वो मैं बता डॉक्टर अजय सूद वाज प्रोफेसर ऑफ प्रिवेंटिव एंड सोशल मेडिसिन इन रोहतक मेडिकल कॉलेज. तो उन्होंने सोचा कि सोशल मेडिसिन क्या होता है, तो उन्होंने डिसाइड किया सोशियोलॉजी में एमए करने का. फिर इंटरेस्ट आ गया, फिर पीएचडी भी कर ली सोशियोलॉजी में. ही ऑल्सो डिड एमबीए DMB. So these are the qualities. So you will see many of our faculty members have जो प्यास है ना और सीखने की और पढ़ने की वो पूरी होती नहीं हमारी, पढ़ते रहते हैं. So if you look at some of the people like Ajay Sood and others in the faculty, वो नाम के पीछे भी लोग कहते हैं सर इतनी सारी डिग्रियां कहाँ से ली आपने, हम पैदा ही हुए थे कि डिग्रियां लेकर के. So in an academic institution, and we in IIHMR Delhi take a pride in calling ourselves a learning institution. And I am the youngest student. So keep learning. Or when we have a faculty meeting, तो रोज हो रही है आजकल faculty meeting, उनमें यही पूछते हैं कि हाँ क्या नया पढ़ा. So all faculty members share. और मैं metro से आता जाता हूँ तो मेरे को 30 पेज पढ़ने को मिलते हैं, 15 पेज जाते हुए 15 पेज आते हुए, रोज में नया नया पढ़ता हूँ. एंड देन वी डिस्कस दैट. सो दैट्स अनदर फीचर ऑफ IIHMR दैट वी ट्रीट आवरसेल्फ एज स्टूडेंट. इवन द फैकल्टी इज लर्निंग एवरी, नोबडी सेज मेरे को सब कुछ मालूम है. इफ यू फील दैट वे देन योर फॉसिलाइजेशन स्टार्ट्स. आप लोग सब बायोलॉजी के स्टूडेंट्स, आप समझते हो फॉसिलाइजेशन. So with that, over to our faculty, starting with Dr. Pradeep Panda. He brings me talk to you, but tell us more about yourself.
Yeah, thank you, sir. So I am Pradeep Panda at IIHMR Delhi. I teach core modules, health economics, health insurance, applied demography, and corporate social responsibility. I have been involved in many research projects as well. And just to cite one, 2 years ago, I coordinated one large scale survey called National Family Health Survey, NFHS-4 in Odisha. And what NFHS-4 does, it collected information from 30,000 households in the state of Odisha.
Like
so basically collected information on health, family planning, fertility, mortality, all key health and family welfare indicators. I have been involved in many training programs, what we call MDP, Management Development Programs. So to cite few of the examples, I coordinated one MDP on economic evaluation of public health intervention. Longitudinal aging studies.
तो ओल्ड जो पॉपुलेशन है वो बढ़ रही है ना, तो भारत सरकार ने कंट्री वाइज स्टडी की है ताकि किस उम्र के लोगों की क्या समस्याएं हैं, उनको कैसे हैंडल कर सकते, उसके ऊपर एक स्टडी. एंड IIHMR इज वन ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशन डूइंग दैट स्टडी इन सम ऑफ द स्टेट्स.
या सम अदर ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम्स ऑफ रेलेवेंस, इंटरनेशनल रेलेवेंस ऑल्सो. फॉर द लास्ट 3 इयर्स आई हैव बीन यू नो providing training for managers in the United Nations Population Fund from 20 countries on reproductive health commodity security as well as vaccine economics for immunization managers in the developing country. It is organized by IIHMR Jaipur and Johns Hopkins University. As regards consultancy, I have also done few. So all people remember we do teaching, research, consultancy, and training and so on. And prior to this, I was actually a health economist at the Population Council New Delhi office. So I worked with 4 service delivery NGOs who were working in family planning and reproductive health in 4 countries in South Asia. Then I was director of research and implementation at another research institute called Micro Insurance Academy, and implemented community-based health insurance in 5 states in India. And prior to that, I was an associate professor at the Center for Development Studies in Trivandrum. It is an ICSSR institution affiliated to JNU. So I guided MPhil and PhD students there. And what is more important is that I'm a researcher. So I have published papers in quality national and international journals. Welcome again. Thank you very much.
Dr. Panda has to travel to Punjab for his study. He is doing respiratory diseases. So we call it called chronic
COPD.
Pulmonary disease. COPD बोलो बोलो तो ना पर वो सांस की ना लोग खांसते रहते हैं तो उसके लिए तो he delayed his departure. Thank you, Dr. Panda, for delaying. Anandi.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome. My name is Anandi Ramachandran. I'm working in the area of healthcare informatics. And as sir has already said, and you all know, right? Technology is everywhere, so meditation is that. So whether it in hospital or health, public health, wherever we can use of technology, I try to learn from that and try to be a part of it. I am still in the learning stage. So when you come and join, maybe together we can try to learn more. See you all soon.
Good morning. Welcome to IIHMR. I am third last on that slide. My name is Dr. Pankaj Talreja.
But very important.
So a couple of things I think that should excite you. One is I started my career as a BDS. So BDS people here? Anybody from dental background? Right. So it is a lovely journey, I can assure you of that, you know. So once you've actually completed your BDS, the first dilemma you have is clinical, MDS or management. So I assure you, it will be a lovely journey. So that is one thing. The second thing is the thirst for knowledge never ends. You know? So I also had the thirst for finance. I actually...
Dental surgeon say finance mein kaise?
Actually, you know, most of the projects when you deal with, finance is a very core area. So how funds are allocated, how to optimally utilize funds. Funds crunch is always there in any project. So I was handling a couple of projects and I realized that finance probably was one area which was troubling all the doctors, right? And so I did MBA in finance. And so I essentially look into healthcare financing of any project. So that is how I actually landed up in finance. And sir has given me additional responsibility of controller of examinations. So when you are here and examinations are bothering you, I'm always here to do, right? So after BDS, I can assure you, it will be a lovely journey. Welcome to IIHMR once again.
So, good morning once again. I am Dr. B.S. Singh. I am your Dean Research. Till date, I have completed more than 2,200 projects myself and with the help of research team. So I am specializing.
You want to ask?
I just mentioned with the help of my team. So I started my career at the age of 22, and still journey is going on. So this is my specialization. I started my career at International Institute of Population Sciences, Mumbai, and I was lucky to involve in the first National Family Health Survey. Because as a National Family Health Survey in 1992-93. And then later on, I was involved in many large scale, small scale, and medium size. Then I moved to USAID funded project, work as a general manager, monitoring and evaluation. And then program side is a project director in urban health for Rajasthan. Then I moved to IIHMR Delhi, joined IIHMR Delhi, December 2013. And started as an associate director. And teaching here, biostatistics and demography. These are the two modules. In addition, there are many other, like data management, disaster management, like that. One thing I would like to say here, seeing this course, our students learn the research in academy. How they research? Through the analysis the data, writing the report, and involvement of student in the many project. As and when we have project, we involve in our student to learn the project. Learning point of view, whatever the finding, we just share this finding with the student. with ourselves among faculty and our stakeholders. And stakeholders is mainly the government of India, state government, particularly NHM, and then UN agency, WHO, UNICEF, and many in, NGO like JAPAIGO and ASTEN. So welcome again.
Nitish. So welcome everyone. I like to keep my introduction a little brief because I would just like to carry on from what Dr. B.S. Singh was mentioning about students and research. So essentially I am a public health physician. I did my MBBS and MD from Delhi University. Then I went on to do an MPH at Johns Hopkins in the US. And a few years later went back there for a prestigious Indo-US exchange program called the Fulbright program. So that's my educational qualification, and my focus area of work has been on the health impacts of climate change, air pollution, and disasters. So all of this you hear about now, but when I started work in this, it's very new. So what I would like to emphasize, with your permission, sir, is about student involvement in research, what Dr. B.A. Singh was mentioning. And I would like to give one example. So in 2011, when sir had literally landed from UNICEF Kenya straight to our institute as research dean, we were carrying out a WHO project which was very, very prestigious because it was being done in 16 countries and we were one of them. And we were struggling as to how to do it because we had very little time and it had to be delivered. So I was asking sir, what do I do about this? And so sir came up with the suggestion that, have you thought about using our students as, you know, it will give them a field experience and you will get your results. So I said, sir, how do I manage so many students, you know? So you involve faculty, that's the way you do, and you work in teams. So under sir's guidance, we did that work. And eventually, in 2014, I was called to present the findings in an international conference in Geneva, in WHO Geneva. And you won't believe it, this was 100 countries, sir, and more than 40 health ministers in front of whom this work was presented. And this work obviously went into the CV of all the students from the C batch. And some of them now are in the WHO themselves. So that's the sort of trajectory and the experience that you get by being in IIHMR Delhi. I don't think you really get too many institutions which provide that sort of platform. So I just like to let you know that. And of course, it's up to you to make your decision, but I'm sure you will come to the right decision. Thank you, Nitish. And we don't expect all our students to go into research. Why we have mainstream research in our teaching is because you are always looking for evidence. Apne hospital ke liye equipment khareedna. Evidence kya? This is the best equipment. One equipment costing 2 crores, another costing 1 crore, which is the best? So you will get that during your training. How do you look for evidence? What are the factors you need to consider? So we are not looking at humare yahan kaam karke sare research paida ho jayenge, nahi. But we will give you that mindset that anything you do in life, you will look for evidence. I mean life, bachchon ki padhai, husband ke saath, career decision, everything in life is based on evidence. So that's what mindset we are trying to give you by mainstreaming research into teaching. So we have
Good morning. I am Dr. Sumesh. I am assistant professor here. I have done MA and MPhil and PhD in economics and I've been finance. So I teach economics and finance. And I love to deliver lectures on soft skills. And after joining IIHMR in 2015, I did a couple of projects in soft skills. I was also involved in one of the largest surveys I was mentioning on elderly people, LASI. We recently completed that survey. And I welcome you all at IIHMR Delhi, and all the best for GDNPM. Thank you so much.
Good morning, everybody. I am Dr. Nishikant Bele. I have done the PhD in the computer science and faculty here in IT. And as an academician, I have published the research paper in the various international journals in the reputed, namely IGI Global InterScience. And also, I am the reviewers for the papers in the international journals, also the many international conferences. Thank you.
Good morning all, I am Dr. Manish Vidal. I did my PhD from JNU and then I joined the government. After that I joined corporate, and after working with the government and the corporate, I found out that I should go to the academics. So I came to academics in 2015 in IIHMR, and I can assure you this is the best place to work in. And for success, this is the only option you have, right? Choosing the right thing at the right time. This is your right time to choose. Thank you all, and I welcome you all to IIHMR.
Good morning, all of you. Myself Divya Agrawal, and I am assistant professor and assistant in academics. And my specialization is human resources and organizational behavior. Regarding my profile, I have done my graduation in instrumentation from Delhi University. After that, I did my MBA from IP University. After doing my MBA, I got absorbed in Maruti Udyog, where I have experience of 5 years of working in the HR profile. I was the senior manager HR and looking after the various disputes and the conflicts happening at the workplace. For the last 15 years, I am with the academia. I am working in the academy world, and I have experience of teaching in the reputed B schools of India. Thank you and welcome to GDPI.
What about your PhD?
I am also pursuing my PhD from MIT University. Thank you.
You got a glimpse of our faculty. Some of them are away. One of our very senior professors is on holiday to spend time with his family in Canada, Dr. A.K. Coker. He heads the hospital management stream, bringing in very rich experience from you name a hospital, he has, like Dr. Agarwal, they have a student or somebody, either medical superintendent running that hospital. He was in ESI. ESI ke jitne medical college, dental college bane na, he was instrumental in setting up those dental and medical colleges. And most of the big hospitals, he was there for about 40 years. So jitne bade bade ESI ke hospital hai, he had his hand in establishing those. So one thing you must have seen, faculty brings in very rich and varied experience. वो कई बार बोलते हैं ना, वो घाट घाट का पानी पिया हुआ है. तो आप क्लास में कुछ सवाल पूछो, दे हैव समथिंग और द अदर टू शेयर इन दैट एरिया. एंड सम ऑफ अस आर नोटोरियस फॉर शेयरिंग स्टोरीज. अच्छा सवाल पूछो ना, मेरे साथ हुआ था, मैंने फलानी जगह था, देन दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंड. सो यू कैन लर्न फ्रॉम देयर रिच लॉन्ग एक्सपीरियंस इन एडिशन टू देयर वेरी रिच एकेडमिक क्वालिफिकेशन. विद दैट आर एलुमनाई, दैट्स इट. कम इन. लेडीज का पर्स देख के मेरे को जेलसी होती है, वो पैसे होते डायमंड डायमंड नो.
गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू, आई एम राखी बालवानी. आई डिड माय ग्रेजुएशन इन फिजियोथेरेपी एंड आफ्टर दैट आई रियलाइज्ड दैट आई हैव सम एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव स्किल्स फॉर व्हिच आई शुड गेट सम अ प्रोफेशनल ट्रेनिंग. सो आई ऑप्टेड IIHMR फॉर माय प्रोफेशनल ग्रोथ एंड आई फाउंड दैट दिस इज द राइट प्लेस टू ग्रो माय सेल्फ एंड ट्रांसफॉर्म माय सेल्फ फ्रॉम अ स्टूडेंट टू प्रोफेशनल. एंड व्हेन आई केम हियर आई My faculty not only helped me to develop my communication skills, my presentation skills and overall, but as a personality, as a person, they helped me to grow. And where I am today is all because of the strong torch bearer of this college, that they always guided me to become a good professional. And one thing I will always share, that jab main yahan aayi thi, I had a lot of dreams in my mind, a lot of queries, a lot of excitement, but ek question tha ki kya I will be able to achieve what I want to. But yes, I can give you an assurance that yes, you are at the right place. And I must tell you, you should always have a quest to learn. And the faculty here are not only the mentors or guide to you at the college, but they will guide you throughout. Even today also I ask my mentors ki main kya karu, and they are always a ray of hope to me. And mujhe bas itna hi kehna hai ki I feel that I graduated from IIHMR, and wherever I go to any hospital in Delhi, I found an alumnus there who not only helped me to get the problem solved but also to grow as a professional. So welcome you all and all the best for your
aap kahan kaam kar rahi hai wo to bataiye.
Confidential
to nahi hai,
bilkul bhi nahi hai. Meri placement yahan se hi hui thi, Sitaram Bhartiya Hospital mein, and I am working as manager in quality. And I really feel that I am blessed at the right place because मुझे बहुत सारे options आए change के लिए, but मैंने change नहीं किया because Sitaram Bhart, when I came to this place, I was sure that I will be choosing the hospital administration as my second year option. I did my internship at Max Pushpanjali in operations, but then I realized that I will not going to take operations as my career, and I will take quality as my career. And luckily, I got blessed that I got the placement to the Sitaram Bhartiya Hospital in quality, and where I was just a senior executive. So when I was in IIHMR, I was taught about how to be a good team member, but gradually I am a manager over there. So my role has been transformed from a member to a leader, and the skills which I learned over there was very helpful. And sir visited Sitaram Bhartiya recently, and Dr. Dogra has also visited Sitaram. And Sitaram Bhartiya is not only the place where NABL or NABH is practiced, it is the one of the few hospitals who actually run quality improvement projects, and their projects are presented in the International Quality Forum. And my two projects, like improvement in the emergency care and improvement in the pediatric care, was presented at the International Quality Forum, Sweden and London. So these are the two achievements. And I was able to achieve because I always had a quest to learn. So every year I used to think one thing, ki aaj is saal main kya naya sikhun. So sir guided me to do some courses from Coursera, which is an online portal. I did some quality improvement courses from IHI Virginia Mason, and then I did my internal assessor certification from NABH also. And recently I am pursuing PG diploma in medical law and ethics, because whenever we used to face the NABH audit, we used to face a lot of queries from the auditor that this is legal or this is not legal. So how should we go about it, and what should be the protocol we should follow in hospital, whether related to the doctors or administrative issues. Like, we recently faced a lot of problems related to code blue, do not resuscitate, and these are the few emerging problems in the hospital we are facing, and we don't know how to go about it. So every time we go to a professional help and they guide us to something different, which actually turns our head, karna kya hai. So we thought that we should actually learn that what is right and what is not right, and we should always formulate our protocols, SOPs around it. So I'm doing that diploma from National Law School, Bangalore. So in the quest of learning. So thank you so much. And
how do you balance your family? इतनी सारी पढ़ाई करते हो, काम भी करना होता है, तो मैंने अपने मन में भी देखी ये सब कैसे पॉसिबल
है. सो पॉसिबल ऐसे है कि यहाँ पर मैंने एक और चीज सीखी थी, वो थी टाइम मैनेजमेंट. सो जब मैं कॉलेज में थी ना, तब भी 9 to 5 वॉज माई कॉलेज, एंड आई स्टे एट ईस्ट दिल्ली कृष्णा नगर. सो आई टू कम्यूट फॉर 1.5 आवर टू रीच हियर. सो आई यूज टू प्लान माई डे अ डे बिफोर कि कल मुझे क्या क्या करना है, वॉट इज माई टू डू लिस्ट. And at the start of the day, I always had that to-do list in my smartphone that today I have to accomplish these tasks. And in the end, I used to analyze that what I have achieved and what is still pending. So I used to analyze that where I am going. मतलब मैं अपनी professional life में इतना ना खो जाऊँ कि मेरी personal life disturb हो जाए. So I used to dedicate, when I am at home, I am at home. I do not discuss about my work or anything else. I spend quality. I stay in a 22 member joint family. So I have so family skills and adjustment skills are in my blood. So when I'm at home, I am the family person. I only focus on my family. And one more thing, the quality skills which I learned at the professional level, I implemented those to my personal life also. Like whenever I when I wake up, I just put a stick note on my wardrobe. This is my to-do list. I have to follow it. and whenever there is a problem, I do not see कि क्या करना चाहिए क्या नहीं करना चाहिए. I do an RCA कि ये problem है ये जड़ है और इसको मतलब I have to solve it. So I dedicate my Sundays, my evenings and everything totally to my personal family and personal related issues, not work. But when I'm at work, I am at work. The only thing when I was placed in Sitaram Bhartiya was कि I will dedicate my professional time to my work only and I will not get distracted. And I had no demands except one, that whenever I get a family call, I'll take. Whether I'm in a meeting or anywhere, I'll take my call. Else I'll not get distracted, but I'll prioritize my family. So this is how I've managed and balanced my work. I hope this will continue.
Thank you so much, Rashi.
And good luck to all.
These soft skills के इन पे मॉड्यूल नहीं है और हम लोग जो पहला एक महीना आपका है वो इन्हीं की बात करेंगे. टाइम मैनेजमेंट की बात की ना, आई डोंट कॉल इट टाइम मैनेजमेंट, आई कॉल इट फर्स्ट थिंग फर्स्ट. शीशी में पत्थर भी डालने हैं, कंकर भी डालने हैं और रेत भी डालनी है. क्या डालोगे पहले? रेत डालोगे? बिग रॉक्स डालोगे? That those are your priorities. You have to be clear what are your priorities in life. So वो सब हम एक महीने का जो आपका induction course उसको restructure कर रहे हैं. Some of these skills we will be teaching you. And thanks, Rajin, for a very good insight into what life is going to be after you pass out. So with that, the most important and dearest stakeholder in IIHMR are students. So over to you. Maybe you can tell them about the value. पांच value ना है IIHMR की, उस पर कोई compromise नहीं. हमारे हर एक student को याद है और जिंदगी भर याद रहेंगे. Quality is one, Rashi is effort. तो बच्चे ही tell you about that. Tell us about yourself and then the value.
My name is Rashi Singhal and I am a graduate of commerce in from Symbiosis College. And our five values, core values of IIHMR are quality, transparency, trust, sharing information, and accountability.
Good, good. कैसा लग रहा है आपको? वो पूछते ना इंटरव्यू करके आपको कैसा लग रहा है? How do you feel about IIHMR?
Okay, so studying in IIHMR feels good because here we're not dependent on too much on teachers. We learn a lot because when we need guidance, they are always there for us, and we can always visit them anytime. They are always available, so we feel good here, and we have a lot of work to do. Not exactly focused on studies, but research work and everything is good here. So it's a blessing for us to be in IIHMR.
Good morning everyone, my name is Manvi Kaushal. I have done my graduation in BSc in Medical Lab Technology. Currently I am pursuing my MBA from IIHMR, Delhi. And now I am doing my summer training internship in Rajiv Gandhi Cancer Institute in Quality Department. Looking forward to all joining this institute and all the best for your GDPI round. Thank you.
जो हमारे स्टूडेंट इंट्रोड्यूस करते हैं ना, तो सारे फैकल्टी के मुंह पे इतने बड़ी स्माइल आती है. बाकी किसी के इंट्रोडक्शन में नहीं है. स्टिल आवर स्टूडेंट.
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. आई एम डॉक्टर रोहित. आई डिड माय ग्रेजुएशन इन डेंटल साइंसेस एंड करंटली आई एम डूइंग माय समर ट्रेनिंग इन राजीव गांधी कैंसर इंस्टीट्यूट. एंड आफ्टर माय ग्रेजुएशन आई प्रैक्टिस फॉर 2 years एंड देन आई वाज लुकिंग फॉर सम अदर फील्ड इन हेल्थ सेक्टर ओनली. And then one of my seniors suggested about this institute, and now after 1 year I can say I'm totally satisfied with my choice. And I welcome all of you.
हम बताएंगे इम्तिहान होंगे, आप भी satisfied. You want to come forward or speak from there?
Now I've been ambushed. That's what we use in parlance in the army. I have been ambushed because I was sitting there. I've been told to just get up and speak. All right. Okay. A very warm welcome to you all. Outside temperature 42 degrees. Inside we are comfortable. All right. Now everybody's been talking about growth. There's something called when you ask a tree, it only becomes bigger. You know, meaning that you never say that a tree is becoming older, you say it is growing. So that is what we are also doing here at IIHMR, I, Colonel Sumit Panthan, 26 years of service to the Indian nation. I'm still growing, I'm still learning. It is a tremendous experience here. I can tell you that there are five basic points that I learned here. And if you don't have this, don't join here. Alright, this is one thing. Firstly is discipline. They lay a lot of emphasis on discipline, timely attendance, and your dress regulations. They are bound by it. I'm very happy about it, that they follow it, because that is already in my blood. So I'm very happy that they follow discipline in the right spirit, number one. Number two, hard work. Let me tell you, if you cannot do hard work, you cannot survive here. 15 days, a fortnight is one capsule. They make you work, they make you slog, but as a team. Everybody has to make a presentation. They make you adapt at computers. So this is one. The second thing that I say that IIHMR gives you, first was discipline, second was hard work. Third, I would say, is bonhomie. We are 100 of us, 106 rather, in the first year. And what bonhomie do we have? We are very happy about it. We are a very cordial team. And it's very interesting to learn from each other. Then the faculty, of course, is tremendous here, learning a lot from them. Infrastructure-wise, IIHMR is very, very well equipped. They've got a wonderful library. They've got a gym here. That helps me. So in all, let me tell you, in case you're looking for a time to spend in a lifetime, spend it here at IIHMR. With this, I'd like to hand over to Divya now. She's a computer specialist from Manipal. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Divya. I've done BTech Computer Engineering. I've worked for 8 years. And I've joined here as a... I'm planning to join healthcare IT, and I think it's a good thing that I've joined here. And I'm very happy that I've joined, and I think this institute has given me a lot to learn. And when I joined, I knew nothing about healthcare, and I feel I've learned a lot. I'm really happy.
I remember when I met Divya for the first time. I normally go to the gym in the morning, so all full of sweat. I walked into the cafeteria. I saw her sitting there with her father. I didn't know what they were doing. Being curious, I said, "Aunt Capital, sir, I'm admission lene aayi." "Sir, can I ask you one question? Are you engineering? Health kaise karungi?" And here she is now confident, bubbling with all the knowledge and expertise. Good, good. Thank you.
Sir. Morning, sir. Morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Colonel Ranjit. I am in the second year now, hopefully. I am an engineer. I have done my master's from IIT Kanpur in industrial and management engineering and BSc BTech. Great field to be in, because right now I am doing my internship in public health in Kerala. Under on the map, and fantastic experience. You know, we never realized that the health system in our country is developing at such a rapid pace. So you all are at, you know, the cusp of getting into a profession which will never find itself going down. It is a profession because as long as people are growing, there will be health issues. So whether it is health, hospital or IT, each one of the fields is fantastic. And I wish you all the best, and for all those who make it, welcome to IIHMR. Thank you.
Thank you. This is what a glimpse of our student, and one very important point that our students come from different backgrounds. And you learn from each other, and we make sure that you work as a team for presentations, groups of 4-5, for various assignments. So that's part of learning. And that is another thing we want to emphasize. You learn from everybody. Security guard to the senior most professor. You can learn from everybody, provided you are open to learn. Mere ko to sab kuch aata, fir this is not the place for you. And you will not succeed in life. So we need to change that attitude that I am here to learn. Every day, read something new, even when you pass out and you are at work, or if you are as dedicated, motivated as Rashid, then go for additional qualification. How many students did you take last year?
26.
This year?
There are alumni, we couldn't get all 2000 plus of them to come and talk to you, but we wanted to give you a flavor how important are alumni for us in placement. And you get 100% placement, not because of faculty, not because of IIHMR, because of the student. To interview lene aata hai na, wo aapko le raha hai, IIHMR ko nahi le raha, faculty ko nahi le raha. So that's what he insists, that you have to be open learning, and that is the impression you should give in the interview. Agar ye impression hoga, sab kuch andar koi nahi le. Director level ke interview mein bhi jaoge, to bhi wo kahoge na sab kuch aata, to koi nahi lega. If you are open to learning, because life is about learning. Sab kuch badal raha hai. Wo dikhaya na scenario. Bachche salary badal gaya, puri duniya hi badal gayi health ki. Technology to aur kuch bhi badalne wala, bahut kuch badalne wala. So that's the culture we want to inculcate, and the values. Five values which IIHMR has. If you can take these values with you for rest of your life, like Rashi said, quality, quality and quality. No compromise on that. So with that, over to you.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiration and guidance. Coming to the end of open day interaction, now I would like to request our student volunteers and the faculty members to take you all to the tour of institute. Ms. Divya ma'am, who is the assistant dean for student affairs, and Dr. Sameer sir, who is the assistant professor, will guide you throughout the tour. After the tour of the institute, all the parents, students and faculty members are requested to kindly gather in cafeteria at third floor for tea and snacks. After the tea, parents and students are requested to kindly wait in the visitors' waiting room number 303, second floor, for the group discussion and personal interview. Our student volunteers will guide you. Thank you all for giving your precious time. Now you may leave for the tour of the institute, followed by tea and snacks at the cafeteria. Thank you.